Hey everyone! As you may have noticed from the thumbnail, today's card was inspired by the movie Jurassic Park. It's one of my all-time favorite movies, so I'm very excited to share this new card with you. So first, the coloring. I started with the car because it was the thing I was the most excited about, and I tried to recreate the same colors as the ones we see in the movie. When the coloring was done, I die-cut several elements to build a background, two grass borders, a hill border, a mountain border, and a rectangle for the sky, all using Strathmore Bristol cardstock. I started by coloring the grass and mountain borders using peel paint and forest moss distress inks. Like always, I covered the whole border using the lightest ink. And next, I added shadows at the top using the darkest ink. When the three borders were done with the ink blending, I smooshed the same ink pads onto my work surface. I added water and created a bunch of splatters on the borders. I wanted to keep the hill border pretty simple because it wouldn't be very noticeable, so I used anti-clinen and gathered twigs, distressing to color that border, and no texture was added. For the sky, I started by applying scattered straw distress ink on most of the panel. I didn't go all the way down because I knew it would be covered by the mountains. And next, I used the cloudy stencil along with a darkest ink, Wild Honey, to create clouds in the sky. Of course, I added texture to that sky by splattering water drops first. I dried the panel using a paper towel, and next I used scattered straw, spiced marmalade, and a little bit of candied apple to add texture to the sky. Next, I assembled the background on an 8.5 by 3.5 inches slimline Noble 4 card base. Before attaching the images, I stamped the second part of my sentiment, Means You're Dynamite, at the bottom of my panel using jet black ink. And next I attached the first part of my sentiment. It was made using the Oliver's ABCs die set. I used a red pattern paper from Willy Rainbow and Grand Coffee cardstock to create shadows. And I used my tea ruler to make sure that the letters were lined up nicely. Next, I stuck all the images using a combination of foam tape and glue dots. Finally, and to make the scene a little bit more fun, I stamped those words, cut them into tiny banners, and attached them above the car critters and next to the T-Rex. And that's it. Welcome to Jurassic Park. I hope you like this card as much as I enjoyed making it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!